smart one, isn't he?
What are you gonna name him?
Do they look like just apes to you?
They're animals!
He saved our lives.
He was remarkable.
Apes, apes, together! Strong, strong!
You're him. You're Caesar. We've been searching for you for so long.
I do not start this war. I fight only to protect apes.
Human gets sick. Ape gets smart. Then human kill ape. But not me. I run.
There are times when it is necessary to abandon our humanity to save humanity.
You say eventually you'd replace us. That's the law of nature. So look what you've done.
What did the humans promise you? No matter what you do, you'll never be one of them. You are a
We are the beginning!
Apes, together!
We are the beginning!
Apes, together, strong!
Have you come to save your apes?
I came for you.
The original Planet of the Apes series was a franchise before the age of franchises. During its 5-year run, a new film appeared almost annually from 1968 to 1973 and was a typical in their time period. The sequels became progressively cheaper and hastier to produce. By contrast, the new Apes series, which comes to conclusion with War for the Planet of the Apes, is a statler affair. The special effects that bring the ape character to life get even more detailed, convincing, and gorgeous. The ongoing story deepens and expands, and the reviews get better. Now, I would say a lot about how the apes are the main focus of this main film, but also there's a great few human additions as well. The Colonel, the young girl, are the only two human characters of any consequence, and it's a bold and smart decision from director / co-writer Matt Reeves. His Dawn spent too much time balancing out its ape story with less interest in humans, while War's ape-centric point of view echoes Conquest and Battle, which follows Caesar's development as a revolutionary. Now, many will refer to the new Apes trilogy as a political trilogy. And it is, in its own way. The Colonel's rage at the idea of being outmelded and his insistence that his troops must build a wall would bring to mind about a certain person in the White House today. But War is more likely to reference Apocalypse Now, repeatedly, than real-life events that have inspired movies like Apocalypse Now. The storytelling is both more grounded and more indebted to past films, Apes and otherwise. This shouldn't take away from War of the Planet of the Apes being one of the best movies of the summer, hands down. Reeves makes great tension with apes banding together in the prison camp that most big movies can't do with a major visual effects smackdown or showdown. But if the series continues, I hope it goes on some stranger, riskier tangents. But to be fair, spoiler alert coming up. Spoiler alert. To be fair, killing off Caesar at the end did bring a tear at my eyes, and if this series was to keep on going, I think it's one of those trilogies that ends perfect, and I think keeping it finished and keeping it ended the way it is perfect, and to carry it on would be to ruin it. They had their big song, they dropped the mic and walk off stage. Sometimes things should end the way they end. And as always, I'm Maverick, you're awesome, and we are Maverick Studios.
We are the beginning!
Apes, together, strong!
We are the beginning!
Apes, together!